Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. But how am I going to? According to the International Energy Agency, they estimate that the world will need to invest $44 trillion between now and 2040 so that it can meet the energy demand for the global population. This is divided into $26 trillion for gas and oil, $8.8 trillion for renewable energy and 9.2 for energy efficiency. That emphasizes the importance of oil globally. We all know the importance of oil, but here my talk is, will there be an alternative to oil in transport? My answer is no, but I want to prove why. That's not working. The biggest chunks of primary energy consumption is transport and electricity. Both account for 30% and 40% respectively. When it comes to electricity generation, there are many alternatives. We have renewable energy, solar power, we have nuclear energy, wind, hydro, geothermal, name it, and we have it there. When it comes to transport, we only have electric cars and a bit of hybrid cars and some LNG-driven cars. Now, let's go and present the facts as we can see them and then see whether there could be an alternative to oil. Few experts have been saying that within the next 50 years, it will be the start, in fact, earlier than that, that with millions of electric cars on the roads, it will be the start of the end for oil. And the tipping point is when 50 million electric cars are on the roads. Now, I would say to that 50 million electric cars will not be a tipping point at all. Why? Because if you look on the global fleet of vehicles, we have 1.2 billion between trucks, buses, and small cars. These use around 32 billion barrels a year, an average of 26 barrels per vehicle every year. Now, introducing 50 million electric cars will reduce the global demand for oil for transport by 1.3 billion, which is 4%. Furthermore, electric cars themselves are a niche. They are not yet a match to the latest technology in conventional cars in terms of range, price, and the ease of charging. Now, recently, ExxonMobil released its outlook of energy to the year 2040. And what they are saying is that they project that the demand, the picture, oil picture in 2040 will not be different from 2015. In 2015, oil accounted for 33.3, I think, percent of the primary energy demand. By 2040, it will still account for the same ratio. And of course, the biggest increase will be in transport. Now, global oil has been increasing, or the demand for oil, year on year by an average of 1.3 million barrels a day. That's 1.5% of the daily demand for oil. This means that by 2030, the demand for oil will be around 114 million barrels a day. Now, if you look at electric cars, out of the 1.2 billion conventional cars on the roads around the world, there are estimated 2 million or under 2 million electric cars and hybrid cars. That represents 0.2, less than 0.2% of the global fleet of vehicles. And of course, part of it, as I said, is hybrid cars. Now, other than electric cars, what other alternative we have? We have LNG, which is being used to some extent to drive cars, but is limited use. Then we have also the compressed gas-driven cars, and there are 14.43 million cars of them. Sizable, but still not big enough to affect the demand for oil, because they are still hydrocarbon-driven cars. And then if you look at hydrogen fuel cells, this is an advanced technology which is getting and moving with great advances, and it could be a good alternative. But what is the handicap is that the technology needs far more improvement than that, and you need more cars on the roads. At present, there are estimated 1,000 cars of them. I have seen buses in Reykjavik which work on the hydrogen fuel principle, but they cost $3 million to. For any company, transport company, they can buy any ordinary conventional car for 100 bus for $100,000, which will do the job, albeit it will cause a bit of pollution. Are we on the verge of a post-oil era? The answer is no. I answered it earlier before this slide, that the tipping point of 50 million by 2024 will be neither here nor there, and it cannot be achieved. A tipping point is when you put around 50% of the current fleet on the roads of the world, meaning 600 million electric cars. Then we start to impact on the price of oil and on the demand for oil. Now, before that, there is a point, even if by a freak of nature or a miracle, there was a replacement to oil in transport. Do you think for 1 minute that the Gulf producers, the Arab Gulf producers, who account for around 50% of proven reserves, will keep that oil underground? They will not. They will use it to fuel hundreds of water desalination plants to convert the Arabian Peninsula into a green land, producing green land, as it was 100 million years before it was converted to oil. Furthermore, they will use it to dominate the petrochemical industries as well as any industry in which oil is a feedstock. So to the answer, will there be an alternative to oil in transport? The answer is an emphatic no, in my opinion, based on what I presented here. Thank you very much. Thank you.